Well, good evening.
Good evening.
I think I can truthfully say that it is a nice evening together. And we're very thankful for that. I'd like to welcome you to Salem Evangelical Church. And we're delighted to have you with us tonight. And we welcome those who are joining us online. We're just glad to have this opportunity to present this 60th Ecumenical Christmas Cantata. And I think back at the founders of this cantata and how pleased they are that we have been able to do this 60 times. It's just amazing. We know it wouldn't be possible if we didn't have that working and relationship with area church that we have, and we're so thankful for that. And we just hope and pray that it continues on for a very long time. I'd like to thank everyone who has any part in this cantata. We just appreciate all your work. And I'm glad that you are all here. The only announcements I make is during the intermission, there will be an offering. And then afterwards, you all invited to join us downstairs. And if you can't stay, we want to have refreshments to go, so nobody can stay on the end. We're glad for that. I'd like you to join me in a word of prayer. Well, Heavenly Father, we thank you for giving us this evening. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this night that we have to share this beautiful message that you give about your promises and the fulfillment of your promise and the gift of our Savior, Jesus Christ, your Son. And we just love to hear the story. It becomes new every time we hear it. And we just are so thankful. And we are thankful for all who are spending and investing their time and their energy and their talents to make this evening possible. And for that, we are thankful. Father, we just pray that you will be with us, and thank you that you give us the ability to enjoy and appreciate this beautiful message and this beautiful music. And we just pray that you will be with us as we read tonight, that we can share the peace and the love and the joy and the hope that you have given to us. And we pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. We will sing our processional hymn, number 39, out of the Greek hymnal. And you are free to stand if you are able.
Thank you.
I am the watchman. From ancient times I have gazed into the night, seeking the assuring light for the morning. Walking the ramparts of the city wall, I ring out the warning when danger threatens. In the still of the night, it is the sound of my voice that offers peace in the shadows. Each hour I cry, all is well, until the silver stars of evening surrender to the golden warmth of dawn. I am a watchman. From ancient times I have gazed into the scriptures, seeking the assuring promises of God. Protecting the fortresses of faith, I shout, sleepers, awake, prepare the way of the Lord. All is well, the sun is coming soon. Day after day, I stand on the watchtower. Every night, I stay at my post and wait. When will the sorrow of my people end? The children of Adam are crushed under the weight of sin. They have forgotten that they are a gift of light from heaven. They cry to me, "Watch me. What is left of the night? Morning is coming. Take heart and keep the watch," I tell them. "See, a Redeemer approaches. The dust of his chariot paints the horizon with the colors of hope and promise. The people who walk in darkness will see a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light will dawn. A Savior will come and will shine with the brightness of his Father's face. He will be the very light of light, the bright and morning star. He will be the Son of God."
Thank you.
righteous ruler is coming. The government will rest upon his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. The dazzling light of heaven will shine in the hearts of the people, and the word of the Lord will be revealed. God will dwell with his creation, and the whole world will be filled with his glory. His kingdom of light will be firmly established and will never end. This is the promise of God.
Thank you.
Listen to my words, people of promise. Be filled with the spirit of hope, for God himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel, God with us. In a small village, this maiden will deliver her child, and he will be the ruler of heaven and earth. This will be a great miracle, a sacred moment the world has long been prayed for. This gentle young woman will hold the future in her arms and cradle the very Son of God close to her heart.
I have traveled offering this evening is for the younger in our midst, in our county, sharing with them the warmth of God's love coming through our hands, as well as people may decide to choose to give cash, which is also used for the same purpose. And so we ask you, Lord, to help us to be generous and grateful. We trust that you care for us. Those here this evening have shared their talents with us, the talents you blessed them with. And now they have shared your glory with their voice. Help us then to reach out with our gifts, to be that sign of presence of your Son in our world today. By our offerings this evening, we share a part of ourselves that others may have the warmth and heat and protection that you desire for all of your children, our brothers and sisters. Name, we thank you for these gifts. May they be blessed, may they multiply, fill the needs of all who need them. We ask this in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.
Sleeper, awake, arise and shine, for your light has come. The glory of the Lord is now made known to you. Legions of angels are proclaiming the news of peace and goodwill to all creation. The hills and valleys that once rang with the sounds of war and conflict all echo with praise and thanksgiving. Sleepers, awake, follow all seekers of light to Bethlehem and worship the newborn King. Let the wonder take you, let the miracle surround you. Sleepers, awake, give yourselves to praise.
Into darkness.
Rejoice! Jesus, the light of the world, has come. Behold, a brilliant star rises to light the way. The night is ablaze with the glory of heaven. Let the hungry come, for they will find the bread of life. Let the thirsty come, for they will find streams of living water. Let the weak come, for they will find the mighty one of Israel. Let the poor come, for they will find treasure more precious than gold. Let the simple come, for they will find wisdom and knowledge. Let the wise come, for they will find the heart of God. Let all seekers come, for they will find rest from their wanderings. Let all the people come and worship. Come and find the one who is born, King of kings and Lord of lords. Hear the word of the Lord. I have set my watchmen upon my walls, O Jerusalem, which shall never hold their peace day nor night. All you that make mention of the Lord, keep not silent. Announce good tidings, proclaim liberty, and declare the dawn of salvation. Christ is born. Bethlehem's stable has become the palace of the King of Kings. Let the entire world rejoice and make known the wonders of his love. I am the watchman. From ancient times I have gazed into the night, seeking the assuring light of the morning. I walked the ramparts of the city wall. I shouted into the silence when danger threatened. Now all that has changed. Jesus, the light of the world, was born. Jesus, the teacher, lived. Jesus, the Redeemer, died. Jesus, the Savior, rose from the grave. And Jesus, the King, will come again. I know that my Redeemer lives, and on the earth one day again will stand in all of his glory. We will need no candle, for Christ himself will be our light. All is well. All is well.
God has given you. And I want us to go out and find people to share those gifts with. We may not all be able to sing and play and direct, but we can bake cookies. We can be kind. We can listen. So, as we go out into the world that is crazy and busy, let us bring the glory of God to all of those that we meet. And may God's blessing be with each of you. Amen.